Good morning. Sorry for the slight delay. We were figuring out microphones downstairs. So, I hope you're all well this morning. As we gather to worship today, let's take in these words. Surely God is in this place. Help me notice. Welcome to Fort Lansing. We're glad you are worshiping with us in person and online today. My name is Varane, and I will bring you greetings from Fort Massey in Halifax on this day, October the 2nd, 2022. It is creation time, the 17th Sunday after Pentecost. And today is World Communion Sunday. If you're worshiping at home, please have elements ready for later in the service. In the sanctuary, please raise your hand if you do not receive elements as you came in, and we will get them to you right away. We'll get them to you right away to be ready for later in the service. Let's experience God bringing us from around the world to Christ's table this morning. I will invite Jenny to play some quiet music while Lily and her helper come forward to light the Christ candle. If you have a candle, I invite you to light it now, or just hold the light of Christ in your heart. Let's begin with being mindful of the gift of God's presence always with us as we light the Christ candle. Spirit of gentleness, flow through us, this light reminding us who and whose we are, as we celebrate your presence, your spirit moving in and through us, reaching out to others, and flowing through all creation, joining us throughout the world. Since time immemorial, First Nations have tended and cared for these lands, learning from, with, and through creation's teachings and gifts. We acknowledge the land and the first peoples of the Mi'kmaq traditions, where we are here in Halifax, and we acknowledge the lands and first peoples of treaties and unceded territories are forever our virtual worshippers are. We all engage in parts to right relationships, to truth and reconciliation, to live in peace and friendship with all people. May it be so. Join together responsibly as we say responsibly the call to worship. The words are in your bulletin and on the screen. We gather to celebrate God's world.
We gather and rejoice in the Son of God.
We gather to eat and remember. Let us pray. Come, let us gather and worship the Lord as we sing praise, feast and pray. Generous and gracious God, how shall we do your will today?
Let it be an act of praise and give share in prayer.
How will you lead us to serve? Bless this community as we come together and worship. For those who can, let us stand for our opening hymn number 509 in Voices United. Here I am, Lord.
Thank you.
Welcome everyone to Fort Massey. May the peace of our Christ be with you. Let's offer each other a sign of peace. My name is Varane Tavuma. I'd like to give our thanks, a very special thanks, to the good Reverend Bill Gillis, who will be presiding at Communion today. I'd also like to thank our special readers and to the clerk session, especially Alison McDonald. Unfortunately, Alison can't join us today because she's unfortunately suffering at home with COVID, so we wish her a speedy recovery. We'd also like to thank our music director, Jenny Trites, who's on the piano and organ this morning. I'd like to thank Jade Frazier and the choir, and we'd also like to thank Jude and Saul Jansen of our tech team, and Jim, Elaine and Daisy Jansen for being our ushers this morning. Thank you as well to our scripture readers and to Sankey and Lily leading our Sunday school and nursery. Announcements are in the Thursday newsletter and are printed in your bulletin. Here are a few highlights. The nominations committee will be meeting on October the 3rd at 7:30 on Sharon Zoom. The committee will be meeting and brainstorming about exciting opportunities in our life and work. So please join if you're at the committee on Sharon Zoom. The Brunswick Mission, the Brunswick Street Mission fundraiser breakfast is taking place on Thursday, October the 20th at 7:30 a.m. in the morning. An in-person catered breakfast at Pier 21 with guest speaker Anna Maria Tremonti will be taking place then. Tickets are $125 and are available online from the Brunswick Street Mission website. You can also call 902-423-4605. Trustees of Fort Massey, there's a meeting for the trustees of Fort Massey on Thursday, October the 20th at 7 p.m. at the manse. If anyone has information to communicate to the trustees, please contact Alan, Peter, James, Anne or Sharon. Please also consult the bulletin for the numerous other notices that are there. Would like to wish a very happy birthday to Linda McDonald, her birthday is on October the 2nd, to Sharon Lee McDonald, whose birthday is on October the 4th, and to my son, Kishinga Tavuma, who's turning 10 today. Unfortunately, he's not with us today, but we wish blessings and our best wishes to all who are celebrating birthdays and anniversaries and other celebrations this week. Please rise and join together in saying, there's a few more announcements, I apologize. I forgot to mention that Sharon is in Toronto with the General Council Office of Vocations, receiving training and orientation as part of the credentialing committee, and will be on study leave in Ontario for the first 2 weeks of October. We should also have in our prayers Bill Gillis' brother, Alan Gillis, father to Angela, Gail and Patricia, who is seeing his final days in the manor in Inverness in Cape Breton. Let's have the Gillis family in our prayers, please, this week. Let us please rise and join together in saying the new creed. The words are in your bulletin and on the screen. We are not alone We live in God's world. We believe in God, who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We're called to be the Church, to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect in creation, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus, crucified and risen, our Judge and our hope, in life and in death, in life beyond death. God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God. We serve God in humility and obedience. As we think of people all over the world celebrating the gift of the Lord's Supper, let's think about what we do to serve God as our offerings are received. Become a foundation of blessings for others, bringing them hope, healing, joy, and peace. Take these gifts to sustain your work in the world, O God. Take our hands in service with the teachings of Jesus. Take our hearts that we might nourish creation as the body of Christ, living and growing. Bless us and all our gifts to spread the message of your great love here and throughout our world. Amen. Good morning to all the young people that we have with us today. I have a question for all the young people. Do you believe you can help our planet? Yes, no?
Will you say it again?
Do you believe you can help our planet?
Yes.
What small change could you make to help the environment?
Get rid of water bottles.
Colleen says getting rid of water bottles and plastic. That's a good one. Any other things we could do? Maybe not use plastic straws. Riding a bicycle?
Plant trees.
What's that name?
Plant trees.
Planting trees. That's a biggie. Yes.
Especially now.
Especially now, yeah, with all the devastation that's taking place. Yes.
Growing vegetables,
yes. In our own garden, yeah. My mom does that. She's done that since I was born, every single year. So all of these things that we mentioned, these are all little things. Right? These are all tiny little things we can do. Right? So growing vegetables in the garden, planting a tree. So imagine if all of us planted one tree, we'd have a forest within a few years. Right? So doing little things one at a time can have big long-term impacts in our world. Jesus tells us that having even a drop of faith as small as a mustard seed Yeah, I have mustard seeds here that Bill very gladly shared with us this morning. So for the young people, these are mustard seeds, right? These are tiny little seeds, right? And if you don't know, these tiny little seeds, when you plant them, even though they're tiny and, really small, you know, if you plant them, they will grow to become a really, really big tree, right? So just in the same way as all of our little actions, when they're all put together, can make a really big difference in our world. And we can change our world for the better. This small bag of mustard seeds can make a real big difference in the world. So even when our faith feels very small, and even when what we are doing seems very small, planting that one small tree, but because God is with us and helping us, all of our small actions can result in really, really big actions and give us really, really big results. Let us pray. Let us pray our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us join in singing our communion hymn, hymn number 418, Voices United. Let us break bread together. As we gather at the table. United Church celebrates an open table. All are invited to share in receiving the hope. All are invited to share in receiving the sacrament of Holy Communion. For those at home, feel free to use whatever you have on hand. For those with us in person in the sanctuary today, the bread is gluten-free. The cup is the fruit of the vine. Grapes. We will take our elements together at the same time. This day, we think of all the people all over the world who gather in secret and in freedom. in homes, in buildings, in open fields, in churches, people celebrating this time to eat bread like ours, different from ours, and some having other foods of their culture. We think of those who will drink juice, wine, or other fruit according to their custom. Our faith in Jesus Christ, seekers and believers in the love of God, unites us all. Join together at this table, Christ's table. All are welcome. God be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to God. Let us pray together. Gracious God, thank you for loving us, welcoming us, and inviting us to this table. Strengthen us in faith, nourish us, and guide us to serve you. In the name of your Son, Jesus. Amen.
We are a village of faith. God's heart is an open door, inviting us to come and gather at the table of love, the table of welcome, the table of forgiveness and freedom. We are a family of faith, gathered around this table, sharing bread, sharing life, sharing the eternal and universal that is in this moment. For Jesus is present here and now in our hearts, in our hands, in our hopes. As we remember stories of his teaching, we experience his gentle touch. As we recall his words of hope and grace, we speak of that mystery called faith. Even as his life was coming to an end, he continued to teach, to heal, and to love. For centuries, Christians of different customs have gathered to commune with each other through the sharing of this feast. In their partaking, we have been with them as we are now. And so we join with our Christian family from all around the world in remembering. On the night in which he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, blessed it, and broke it, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in the remembrance of me." After supper, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shared for you and for all. Do this in remembrance of me." We were intending to have about 4 readers in various languages. We are grateful to have 2 readers today. Ian is bringing the mic forward now. Ian's coming.
She could use the lectern.
"이것은 너희를 위하는 내 몸이니 이것을 행하여 나를 기념하라 하시고 식후에 또한 그와 같이 잔을 가지시고 이르시되 이 잔은 내 피로 세운 새 언약이니 이것을 행하여 마실 때마다 나를 기념하라 하셨으니 너희가 이 떡을 먹으며 이 잔을 마실 때마다 주의 죽으심을 그가 오실 때까지 전하는 것이니라. 아멘." 아멘.
경계 예방 문제 여부세 본시 아르마인의 동해 내리 본자이 기프라구 예수 내 제사와 바카라와타 가야 로티니 아르 단야완 그렇게 우세 도리 아르 카하 के मेरे दर हैं जो तुम्हारे लिए हैं मेरे स्मरण के लिए नहीं किया करो इसी अतिरिक्त से उसने बिरयारे के पीछे कटोरा भी लिया और कहा ये कटोरा मेरे लोगों में नई वाचा है जब कभी पियो तो मेरे स्मरण के लिए यही किया करो क्योंकि जब कभी तुम ये रोटी खाते और इस उस कटोरे में से पीते हो तो प्रभु के मृत्यु को जब तक वो न आए प्रचार करते हो
Thank you to Jennifer Lee reading in Korean and surprise Ian McDonald reading in Hindi. Surprise to me. God, we remember and give thanks for your Son, and we ask that you bless and pour your Spirit on these simple gifts of bread and the fruit of the vine. The bread nourishes us for the journey. Reminds us of the blood of Christ shed for us. With these elements, eternal God, may you nourish and sustain us, our Creator, our Redeemer, our Sustainer. Praise be to you now, tomorrow, and always. We gather now at this table. All is ready. Come for the sharing. Let us pray. We pray the food we have eaten and the drink drink we have tasted. It may continue to remind us of your unending love. May your Spirit speak to us. May we be blessed to live in faith and humble service. Amen.
Scripture reading is Psalm 137, Voices United, page 858-859, and this is a responsive reading. So many papers, sorry. If by the rivers of Babylon, then we wept. There we wept. By the rivers of Babylon, we sat down and wept when we remembered Zion. There, our tormentors called for entertainment, saying, how could we sing the Lord's song in this strange land? Let my tongue stick to the roof of my mouth if I do not remember you. The apostle said to the Lord, increase our faith. He replied, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the sea, and it will obey you. Suppose one of you has a servant plowing or looking after sheep. Will he say to the servant when he comes in from the field, come along now and sit down to eat? Won't he rather say, prepare my supper, get yourself ready and wait on me while I eat and drink. After that, you may eat and drink. Will he thank the servant because he did what he was told to do? So you also, whom you have done everything you were told to do, should say, we are unworthy servants. We have only done our duty. Offered his wisdom for the journey.
Just as folks are getting into place, I would like to say I hear some lovely singing from the congregation today. And if anybody has ever been curious about joining us, I do encourage you to come join us on Thursday nights. We're happy to see you with any level of experience or any level of commitment if you can join us every week like many of our wonderful regulars, or if you can join us once in a while. Feel free to ask me questions after the service about that.
Thank you, Colleen, for reading. And thank you, Jamie and choir. That was beautiful. So today is World Communion Sunday. As we know, World Communion Sunday is observed by several Christian denominations across the world, usually taking place on the first Sunday of every October. This is a day where many different Christian denominations are united in observance of the Eucharist and are reflecting and committing to actions that together, as a united Christian body, we can take in worship of our Lord Jesus Christ and in doing so make a better world for everyone. So I've been asked to speak very briefly about World Communion Sunday, focusing on how it's experienced in other parts of the world. And as you know, I am originally from Zimbabwe, which is in Southern Africa, and I'll very briefly share with you that perspective. In Zimbabwe, the Methodist Church, we don't have the United Church of Canada in Zimbabwe, obviously, so I was born into the Methodist Church. The Methodist Church has over 40 elementary and high schools dotted around the country, providing an education to thousands of students. The Methodist Church also has a university, African University, a Pan-African University that is in my hometown of Mutare. Today, during the World Communion service, in my old church, in the Methodist Church and in many other churches, Dawavui. So say Wavui. Wavui. Vu is a unique Shona sound. Like the Zulu people have a click. Shona has these unique sounds, Vui. So Dawavui is the men's choir. It's typically a lot of the older gentlemen in the church will join the men's choir. It's a strong tradition in the Methodist Church in Zimbabwe. And they practice a lot and they sing these really deep, wonderful songs. So typically, on a day like today, the Wavui, the men's choir, would have sung several hymns in Shona, accompanied by the rattling sound of what we call the Osho, what in Canada we call the maraca or a shaker. That's the only instrument they use, just their voices and the shaker. Also on this day, people have sat through the usually 3 hour long church service. So, you know, it takes quite a, you know, it's quite a commitment, especially as a kid. When you go to church every Sunday, you know, 9 until 12 o'clock every Sunday. And typically you get a little bit early. And in my case, my mom is very chatty. So she'd be chatting to people for at least 30 minutes after the service, so it's like a 4 hour event sometimes. But the main thing, typically on a day like today, the message that is given is to reaffirm that all Christians and all denominations are Christ followers. And there's also a tradition where people of different denominations will attend different churches. So my aunt, who's Catholic, would often come to our church, and we'd go to the Anglican church on this day. Importantly, though, there is a special offering that is taken on World Communion Sunday in the Methodist tradition. This is the World Communion Special Sunday Offering. Gifts given on this day are used to support a vast, diverse, and incredibly large set of students and educational institutions, helping them to achieve their education goals, whilst also transforming communities throughout the world. The offering taken on World Communion Sunday has kept many children in school and helped keep many schools running and even helped those schools thrive. One of those schools is Hartzell High School in Old Mutare. It's been running since 1898. It's a missionary by the Methodist Church that was started in 1898 to educate African children. It's a school that my dad went to. It's a school that my granddad taught at. And it continues to educate many thousands of students to this day. And across the small valley where Hartzell is, there is Africa University, where I did my undergraduate studies, and it continues to provide a higher education to many thousands of students. So the coming together on this special World Communion Sunday, where Christians of many various denominations all worship together and are inspired to change the world, has contributed to the miracle that is the education of many thousands of people and the development of communities throughout the world, such as mine in Mutare and Zimbabwe. Let us today, on World Communion Sunday, continue to find ways to inspire change in all our communities throughout the world through the common observance of the Eucharist, and to unite, to commit, and to make our world the kingdom of God. Amen and amen. Let us pray. Generous God, we look at how you sustain and nurture the world, and we are awed at the beauty. We see the love of friend and neighbor, discovering it is your love we receive. We hear the sounds of creation, birds, children, music, laughter, and it fills us with much joy. Thank you for the wonder that surrounds us and stirs our hearts. Ever-present God, we thank you for offering the bread of life, how it sustains and nurtures your children. We listen to the call of the mustard seed, the call to offer service in all we do. Help us to hear the call of the world, that we may all serve and eat together. We pray for the places in our world that are broken. We hear the cries of the people who are suffering. We feel the hearts that ache for justice. Be with all peoples working to sustain the beauty and health of our world. Nurturing God, your land is abundant with stories and peoples. Thank you for the richness of creation, for the mountains to the sea, for the first peoples of the land and all who now call it home. Remind us to listen to the wisdom of all stories, to fill us and sustain us throughout our lives. Let every soul be fed by your presence. Loving God, we pray for your church. Continue to guide us in our discipleship. Challenge us to serve, sustain us by your love. Be with those who suffer in body, mind, and spirit. Strengthen them. Help us to live more holy as the body of Christ in the world. Holy God, we know you feel the words on our hearts before they touch our lips. Continue to be with us throughout creation. Continue to love and continue to be with us. Amen. Please join us to sing our next hymn. Hymn sent forth by God's blessing, Voices 9481. We go forth to share the community of the Spirit, aware of the need for peace and hope to be felt throughout all creation. Set a place for all who hunger. Fill the cup of all who thirst. And, as you go, may the Spirit of power and love attend to you. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ uphold you, and may the great faithfulness of our God sustain you. Now and forever, God bless you and Amen.
Thank you so much.